Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Ezinwa Noma and today I'll be sharing with us the things you need to know before you start your applications. I mean, this information are the information you're supposed to gather, the very, very first information that you have to gather before you start your application for your international studies, be it Australia, be it Canada, wherever you want to go to. These are the major things you need to know. Okay, now, number one, first of all, you need to find out the country you want to go to. I'm aware that so many people, they'll just, you know, kind of just put the whole load on an agent. Like, okay, I want to study abroad. I don't know. The agent will be the one to look for the school. The agent will be the one to look for the country and all that. No, you don't have to be so. You need to know these things at the back of your mind first. It's going to guide you because many times after maybe the agent have helped students gain the admission and everything, and they go back and they go to that country, you find out that most times you're not even happy, you don't like the country, you don't like the way they behave, the people and all that. So you need to be able to find the country you want to go to. You want to go to Australia, you want to go to Canada, Germany, UK, US, wherever you want to go to. You need to be able to locate that country. I'm like, okay, this is the country of my choice. This is where I want to study. This is where I want to do my international studies. Check if this country, if they are accepting of other races. Yeah, there are some countries that are not so good with, you know, accepting, interacting or mingling, or, you know, with maybe Africans, just for example, I'm just saying. And you need to check if you're the kind of person that wants to, I mean, you know that this school fees that will pay, this fees that will pay here, it's not beans, like it's a whole lot of money, and you need to make good use of it. You need to gather out the whole package, everything that's involved. Studying abroad is not just to go to school and come back. No, you get the education. You also need to be enlightened. It's also a time, it's also a privilege for you to see other places. Now, if you're someone like me that like to explore, that like beautiful things, like me, I chose to study in Australia. That's because Australia is a really, really beautiful country. Like, seriously, Australia is very, very beautiful, you know? So I chose to go there, and there are a lot of good things, landmarks that you are hearing and you're reading from your books that you've heard before, some famous historical landmarks, you know, and all that. All those things were also part of my consideration. I mean, which is nothing, there's nothing bad, I mean, wrong with it. You can't pay all those huge amount of money and it's just for you to just get education. No, there should be more. You need to check if that country is a multicultural country. Like, do they have other cultures, other things? Because that will enable you to know that, okay, since this country is a multicultural country, you are sure to find other people like you. And also, they can also accept your own kind of culture. You get that? So it's really important to identify the country you want to go to. You need to know, okay, amongst all this country, this is the country I need to go to. Then, hey, before I forget, another important thing, again, in knowing the country you want to go to, is that it's not all countries that are really, and when it comes to education, you know, they are not really in the forefront, you know, globally. You need to check this country, are they known for global? Then another thing you want education, to do again is that you want to be sure that, okay, this place I'm going to, this country I'm going to, what is at the back of your mind? Do you intend to come back after your studies? You need to know from here. It's not when you get there that you start deciding. You need to know, do you intend to come back? Will you want to come back, or will you want to remain there? Now, if you want to remain there, there are things you have to do, and you have to start doing them from the beginning of your application. It's really important. And then if you want to come back, there are things you need to do. There's a way you have to apply. It's really important. All these things, agents will not tell you. They don't usually tell these things. It's only when the student gets there and, you know, they will just find out all of this thing, and they are disappointed and things like that. So you need to know if you want to remain there or you want to come back. So your decision matters. If you're going to remain there, then the way you apply your application differs. The courses you need to apply, the location of the university and all that is very, very important. Don't just carry yourself and just move to an agent. I want to do this without having this knowledge of what you want to do. They'll just do whatever they want to do for you. And at the end of the day, once they have succeeded in getting you your admission and your visa, that's all. They don't care. You'll be the one to face all the whole challenges when you get there. So you need to know whether you want to remain there after your studies or you want to come back home. And another thing you need to know again is you need to know if the university, you need to know if the university is internationally accepted, that particular university. Now you need to know this for yourself. Well, I am not against agents, because I too, I use agents, but it's important you know what you do. You know what you're doing. It's important you know what your agents are doing for you. Because, like I always say, at the end of the day, you'll be the one to suffer all these things. You can pay all those money and you get a certificate from a university that is not internationally accepted. For what? For those big money that we pay. I mean, seriously. So you need to be aware. Because one thing that some of these agents do, they are accredited to some, they have affiliation to some of these, some universities. So they always find a way to lure their students to go to those universities. You know, not considering what those students want. So if the university, they are trying to, you know, get you to accept, you know, if it's okay with you, good and fine. But you need to have this knowledge. You need to know if these universities are okay. You get me? So you need to know if by yourself, you need to know that, okay, this university, read about them, how far they have gone, and their international acceptance and all that. It's important. I mean, like, it's really, really important. So you need to know that. Don't leave your everything for an agent to do. I always keep saying that because I've seen a lot of students who cry after all this thing. They begin to, like, you know, wail and regret and all that. So you need to know. When I was doing my, I did a lot of research. I see my book. This book is what I use. I got it. Get a notebook like this. Thick one. Don't even get a notebook like this and document your information. Everything you're finding out, document them. Document them. I don't know. If you want me to do a video on the processes of this research, like the processes, I mean, you cannot just be here and here and here and here and all that. It's going to confuse you. So if you want me to do a detailed process on how to go about this research, let me know. Let me know in the comment section, and I'll do the video. If you don't want the video, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to waste my time on something that people will not watch, you know? So I'd like to see your comment. If you want me to do that video, I'll do the video on how to, you know, do a detailed research, step-by-step research, that it will help you, to be easy for you. I'll do that video for you. Okay, before I go into the next thing I have to say, please, at this point, if you have really watched this video from this point, please, I would like you to, you know, consider subscribing to my channel. This will support me, like, you know, subscribe to the channel, give me a thumbs up and comment. It's going to, you know, support me. It's going to encourage me to keep putting out this video. Seriously, like I was saying, I said in my other video, when I started my journey, my application and all that, I didn't see, there were no much videos. Like, it was really hard. I had to do the whole research on my own. I mean, okay, personally, I'm someone that likes to know everything about what I'm going to get involved. So it was really a challenge. I didn't see anywhere, no clue, no links, nothing. But I just started from the scratch. I had to do all this thing. So I just felt that, okay, if I'm going to finally be able to, you know, get through this thing, I'm going to come back here on the YouTube to share, to help people, to give tips and advices on how to go about this. So please, if you have watched this video until now, that means that this content is really, really, really beneficial to you. So please help me click on the subscribe button and turn on your bell notification. Turn on your bell notification so that you'll be notified anytime I post a new video, and give me a thumbs up and comment. Ask your questions, whatever questions you want to know, ask your questions and I will reply you, or I will do a video about that. All right, so let's get into the next thing that we have to say. So if another thing you need to know is you need to know that country you're going to, or the location you're going to, maybe inside that country, the university where it is situated, you know, the environment. Is it a place that you're likely to get a job? Like, you know students, they work while they study. You understand? Is it a place that you're likely to get a job, to get something? It's really important though. It's important, my dear, because by the time you get there, there are people that they will get to their school 6 months, they've not gotten anything to do. I mean, and it's really hard. Seriously, you need to put into considerations all those things. And I think that is it for now. for now. That is, you need to put into consideration of all those things. These are the things that need to be at the back of your mind. I think these are the most important. There are other things, but I think these things that I just mentioned now are the very, 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 very important things that you need to put at the back of your mind before ever you start. You need to know where you're going to fall. You need to pick the country. You need to know about those, about the country. Know how their culture. Know about your universities. How far are they globally accepted, and all that. You know, just generally, you need to get all this information first at the back of your mind before you begin to apply. And remember, always do your research. Always do your research. In this channel, I've already said that before, I'm going to be posting videos. I'm going to be posting links and things that will help you, that really helped me in my own search. Especially if you want to become an international student in Australia, I'm going to be posting all those things that would help you. And again, I'm going to say here that I am by no means a registered migration agent, nor am I a registered education agent. I'm just sharing my experience. I'm giving you guys tips that can help you, that could help you. My experience might not be your experience. It might help you, might not help you, but this is my experience. This is what I did. This is what helped me. And I decided to come and share with you guys. Who knows? One or two persons might benefit from it. And if you know anyone that is looking to travel abroad, to study abroad, to do masters abroad, or to study in Australia, please do well to recommend my video to them. I promise you, it's going to be really, really interesting and helpful. Thank you. God bless you.